Okay, so this is about Earth and Life Science naman, Quarter 1, Module 5, Stratified Rocks. So again, ang as you notice, ang picture, wala niya na colored because gin-print niya siya naman, gin-raiso, so para hapo. So anyway, let's go back, or let's read the I need to know part. So this module was designed and written in you in mind. It is here to help you describe how layers of rocks stratified are formed and describe the different methods, relative and absolute dating, to determine the age of stratified rocks. So the scope of this module allows you to use it in many different learning situations. The language used recognizes the diverse vocabulary level of students. The lessons are arranged to follow the standard sequence of the course. So this module is composed of two lessons. We have lesson one, formation of stratified rocks, and lesson two, relative and absolute dating of stratified rocks. So after going through this module, you are expected to describe how layers of rocks are formed, differentiate relative dating from absolute dating, identify the different principles in determining relative dating, identify the different methods in determining absolute dating, and describe the different methods in determining the age of stratified rocks. So, I will check on this part, answer in the following in capital letters. So, again, we have 10 questions. And then, lesson one, formation of stratified rocks, you will have the lesson overview. So, we have here the different rock layers, how layers of rocks are formed. And then, so I will do this part, activity one, bedrocks underneath. So what are the materials you will need? You will have your pencil or ball pen learning answer sheet. So procedure, suppose you are going to identify the stratified rocks under your feet, shown in figure two. Determine the oldest and the youngest layer. So arrange the stratified rock from oldest to youngest order, refer to figure two. So, sa inyo, since wala ka mo answer sheet, what you will do is simply, ano lang, himo na lang ka mo daw layer, balang or mas ili layer, daw box na lang, tapos hindi nga mga layers, so each one yung mga layers, i-under, ano nyo lang, i-box-box nyo lang, buta nyo lang limestone, shale, sandstone, to granite. And then, i-identify mo, number mo lang, number one as the oldest, and 2, 3, kag 4 is the youngest. So, i-arrange mo lang. Next, analysis questions. Answer the following questions below based on figure 2. What is the oldest layer? What is the youngest layer? Arrange the layer from oldest to youngest order. Describe how layers of rocks are formed. So, answer in 3 to 5 sentences. Then, I learned this, fill in the blanks, select your answers from the word box inside here. So the choices include stratification, composition, origin, strata, stratigraphy. Next, I practice this now that you have the knowledge about how stratified rocks are formed and the geological events that alter the layers. Label the diagrams below either folded, tilted, intruded. Answer the blanks or answer the blanks below. So, right lang or inner case, number yun lang 1 to 4 and then ang choices, folded, tilted, or intruded. So, ang choices. Okay, next. So, I apply this, identify the oldest rock, youngest rock, and the geological events occurred in the stratified rock based on the diagram given below. So, oldest, youngest, and anong event? Oldest, youngest, and anong event? And oldest, youngest, anong event? Ang key, is conglomerate. Ang amuni is limestone. Ari is shield. Amuni is sandstone. Okay? Next. Ang event nga namin niya da is folded, tilted, or intruded. So, amuni events. Ibot ang next, I test myself. Answer again in capital letters, 1 to 5 questions. Then go to lesson 2, relative and absolute dating of stratified rocks. So simply read lang some relative dating So may mga figures na da, which is also shown. Absolute dating. So as you notice, we convert na siya sa black and white. Okay, amo na parang pwede na mag-ISO. So I will do this part sa material scissor paste yellow pad. For activity 1, it's entitled the rock age and then rock layer pictures. So cut the pictures and paste it to the identify the law used to determine the relative age of the rocks. The cutting of pictures, please refer to page 8. So my source siya, so page 8 na siya. The pictures to ato sa page 18. So mag-goes ta sa page 18 anay. So amo ni siya. Youngest, oldest. Amo ni youngest, amo ni oldest. Amo ni siyang page 18. Narada. So anyway, balik ta di. And answer the following questions. So in our case, do not cut our module. All you have to do is to answer in your paper. Okay. Next. Ang sa paper nga answeran, Ariho, what is the law of superposition? So write your answers. Which law states that sediments are originally laid down in horizontal layers? Then which law states that rock layers on either side is the same when rock are laterally extended to both sides? 4, faults and intrusions are always blank than the rocks that they cut through. Next, 5, describe the different principles in determining the relative age of rocks. So answer it here. Okay, next. I learned this again. Select your answers from the box. The choices are spectrometer, relative, decay, radioactive, absolute. I practiced this part. Imagine that you are a geologist. You visited a mine site where you found stratified beds of rock. You are tasked to sequence the pattern of the rock layers as shown in the figure below. Assume that sedimentary rocks are deposited under water and erosion happens above water. How are you going to sequence the layers of events from oldest to youngest? So write the letter on the space provided. So ang oldest, amo ni 2, 3, 4, 5. So anong sequence yun? You check. Okay, next. I apply this. So based on what you have learned in this lesson, draw simple stratified rock diagram illustrating from youngest to oldest in this order, shale, sandstone, limestone, with a fault as your geological movement that cuts all through the layers. Draw inside the box and use the key provided. Sorry, ang key, conglomerate, limestone, shale, sandstone. So, simply draw. And then answer 1, 2, 5 questions. So, amo ni siyang kakainang ato niya, din ansiran. Or amo ni siyang ato niya sa activity. Ito mo lagi ina. So, diri ang inyong abasihan. So, again, don't forget sa punta, may rada post test niya alansiran. So, don't forget to answer the post test. It's also 1 to 10. Okay? So again, if you have questions, simply ask me from our group chat.